Hey guys, and welcome back to Empyrion on Landstryder's realm. I am Twitchi, and it is time to make this platform great. We can see that we are a little bit undefended here, and I want to build a wall around all of this, because there's a slime wanting to come in and steal my floor, and we are not going to have that. Oh no, indeed. But that is not the only troubles I have at the moment. One of the other problems I've got is the fact that I've got no food on the go. And if we come and have a look in here, we can start growing food in these growing plots. The problem there is we need some nutrient solution, which is thankfully made just over here. But you can see that we have some issues with the purified water. Now, the rock dust we can get nice and simple, but purified water, where do we get that from? So I'm going to go over towards my large constructor over here, and I'm going to hope that in here, if we scroll on up, we've got the water generator. So I'm going to click on that and see if this is the thing that I need. I'm kind of just betting that it is. I hope. Oh, look, I've got a whole load of bullets here that I can take away. I'm 500. I was about to say, I'm not sure what the maximum these bullets can stack to is, but hey, look, we just found out it's 500. So we need to go and place this down here somewhere. It tells me it needs to go into water, so you can see it's it reckons this is water, does it? Okay, we're going to put this somewhere close to the base, near the generator, so that we can just kind of jump off and go back. I'm wondering whether we want to actually be on that side. No, we're going to put it here, just here. If we need to move it, we can. Pow, job done. So in here we should have no energy. I think I know what's wrong here. Let's try something else. Left shift and click to pick up. Here is the generator, but I'm going to see whether we can put that in our hands. You remember last time when we placed down the gun turret, we had to come over to this base, press and hold N, connect to base. Yeah, that's the one I'm looking for. There we go. Connect to base. There we go. Let's try this now. Let's see if this works as well as I'm hoping it will. That was a little bit of blood there. A little bit of blood. No, it doesn't seem to like it here now. I thought this was going to be better than it was. Okay, so what I'm going to have to do is build a whole line of stuff off, maybe? Maybe. So after taking a moment to actually have a look at the stuff, you can see we've got energy items up here. Did I throw everything in there? Give us this back. I'm sure there was another two. There they are. I wonder how I completely missed them. You know when things are just hidden in your inventory and you're like, no, I can't see them, and then they're exactly where you thought they were. So we can do that. This is now on, and it should start producing water jugs. Next production in 100 seconds. Oh man, this game really is all about waiting. So whilst we're doing that, let's go around and try and collect some materials. I am super in need of aloe vera and fiber, because whilst I still do have 13 healing there, it would be pretty nice to be able to increase that. Also, fiber is used for a lot of other things indeed, including the crop plots. Ooh, here's something we've not seen before. Triceratops. Just to point out, I am literally just across the hill. Like, there's my base over there. Small little tree section over here. Forested area. Just seeing if there's anything worth messing with over here. I'm definitely going to go and grab this honey here. Not doing too well on the aloe vera. I believe I found one piece, but that's it. I've loads of sugarcane. All the sugarcane I could definitely want. Carver beans, can make those into coffee. But yeah, all in all, pretty slim on the healing, the aloe. Ooh, what's this? Alien plasma ZR1. Oh, that is something I need for a healing kit, I'm pretty sure. Oh, look. There's a walking banquet just over there. Should we try and take a few of them out? I think I've got the bullets. Yeah, 500 bullets. Let's do this. Should be able to just to burst it out. Hopefully, that's one. Oh, they're getting close now. Let's just let rip onto him and run away. Reload at the same time as turning to look. We've got people going nuts over there. I say people, animals going nuts over there. Go on, just go down. Oh, dead man's click. I was kind of expecting these to go down a little easier than this, but it shouldn't be too much of a problem. That's a headshot. Oh, he got me from a distance, but that's fine. Thankfully, none of the stray bullets went and got the Triceratops. I mean, could you imagine if we did that? So, 4 bits of meat. That's nice. There really needs to be a quicker take everything and close the window button That doesn't exist, unfortunately. Oh, is that a little bit of aloe in front of me there? Do you guys see it? I see it. Let's go and have a look. So much meat. Overflowing with meat. So I found a small patch of aloe that's ripe for picking. But I'm a little worried about what that is. I've not seen one of those. Alien insect. Lots of things register as alien insect. I saw a bipedal thing earlier on that registered an alien insect and then started trying to kill me. It was disgusting. Well, it wasn't disgusting. It was disgraceful. Oh, look, more aloe. Oh, all the aloe. So the alien plasma appears to be for the small medikit. If you look over there, this and 5 water. But we need 2 of those, so that's a little bit unfortunate. Is it the ZR1? I wonder what else we've got that uses. Probably nothing. Probably nothing. Salami, no. Okay, yeah, no, I'm not seeing any more healing there. So we're going to have to keep an eye out for that. Little mushroom. Let's go and see if our water has come in, because that is the thing we are missing here. We've got some water jugs. Now, I do know that we can turn this into purified water up here. Whoop, jetpacks away. If we come in and drop that there, we should now... Ooh, coffee. We should be able to make this purified water by the bucket load. Water jug, oh, it takes 1 for 1. That's a little unfortunate, as I actually need like... Oh, no, it's 10. 1 for 10. That's brilliant. That's brilliant, because we pop that in there and look all the way down the bottom here. We now need some rock dust. We should be able to make all these nutrient solutions. In fact, just like that, I think we can click ourselves. I don't know. Let's put 4 or 5 down. 6. 6 sounds like a good number of crop plots to make. Just got to wait for the... Well, I suppose we can... No, we can't cancel this because it's obviously in the middle of working right now. An alien honey plant sprout. Ooh, that would be nice. Maybe we could make some of that. All these different sprouts. Thankfully, I do have a selection of sprouts already, aloe vera being one of them, though I am going to put these 13 aloe vera chunks in here along with the sugar cane. Yeah, I've got quite a few. Ooh, space durian sprouts. That's nice. So looking at what I've got here, the aloe vera and the fiber, let's put one of those on to go together to make my bandages. So we're going to do that. I would like to get one of these alien plasma sprouts on the go if we can. Is that something that's even here? No, it doesn't look like it's actually here. That's a little bit of a shame. Just a little one. Okay, so it's time to start talking about base layout. Now, I've had this pictured in my mind as this being my sort of my garage area. This is where I come and put like my hover vehicles and my motorbike. And it's probably going to be too small to keep anything other than that in there. As for my farming, as this is the thing we want to place now, if I come along and do this again, can we do the connected to base? Yes, we can. I really should rename my base, but I think we're going to put the farms out this way somewhat. I definitely want to be on a lower level than this. Do you reckon we can do here? This looks good. This looks super good. Maybe looks a little low actually, but we can live with that. Now we're not going to be able to get the full 3x3 in, but we can definitely do this little 6 patch here. I'm not sure about this. Should we try and drill a little bit away? I tried to do this up there, you can see, to get rid of some of the grass, but that didn't turn out too well. So let's try this here. Ah, that's almost exactly what I wanted. I can deal with the weeds. I can live with that. So let's go and... Oh no, let's not go. Let's grab these and plant them. This is, of course, the next bit of our quest. The durians kind of just get made into space fries, so that should be good. Let's pop that down like that. We've got here, what is this? That's the carver coffee beans. That's good. I'm going to put my fiber up this end, and then we'll have aloe vera in the middle. And maybe at some point we'll make another aloe vera, or perhaps we'll feel that we need something else. Okay, so the next thing we need is a grow light. Let's come over to my large container here. One of the things I'm going to have to do is go out and find more promethium at some point, because I'm going to run out of power soon. And I shudder to think what would happen if I run out of power with no way of making more power. That would just... Well, you guys would laugh at me, mainly. Of course, I spent ages looking through the constructor there trying to find this plant grow box, but here it is. I need to purchase it. Grow light, sorry, not grow box, grow light. And then it should just be there. Cool, we're going to add one of these. I mean, maybe we'll add a few more. Oh, look, we made some glass plates. I think I would also like to make some trussing. Let's make 10. We can add that to this, and then we're going to make a... almost a glass house type, a greenhouse, sorry, type effect. I think probably the three is as wide as it's going to go. No, it's not. It's going to end up six, isn't it? We're going to have two rows of three with a walkway down the middle of two wide. Okay, I'm planning. Planning is working here. I think I would also like some wooden blocks. So I've been building throughout the majority of the night. Ah, that won't skin like that. That is quite unfortunate. And I think I've reached a building style that I kind of like. It definitely does the job here. You kind of have this as the front face, and there's a little walkway going on in here. It's not very easy to spot what's going on, though. So let's put our grow light up here. This is why I needed this line of trussing here. So it would softly illuminate this area. Now, I was planning to actually put it in the middle here, but after looking up on the wiki, it only does a 3x3 area, two blocks underneath it, which makes that the perfect spot for it. Let's fly on up here. Of course I fell down the hole. Why would I not? Okay, I'm going to go and run up the outside. And we can talk about glass roofs. So, ooh, there we go. There, the glass takes a long time to smelt. I really cannot impress upon you how long it takes to smelt. But thankfully, you do get like little 2x2 panels. I say little 2x2 panels. You get quite large 2x2 panels here. They are a little unwieldy on my odd-sized building, though. You can see here that I've only really allowed for 3x3s, if you will. And that's not really working too well for me here, but I can definitely deal with it. Let's go around this way. I thought I would let you guys join in on some of the building. Did that go where I wanted it? Cool. I found out after I'd built the truss shape that this 2x1 was a thing. Now, unfortunately, it's at the wrong slope for providing windows for what I want. Let's put it down here so we can see. You can see that slope there is a 1x1. And if I orient... That's not the orientation I wanted to orientate it by. If I orientate this down that way, it's a completely different type of slope. Now, I could have ripped it all down and started again, but I'd already had my heart set on this. So this is what we are going with. Some place I can take advantage, though, is this one. We can find the right axes to spin by. You can end up putting them across like this. So that has definitely saved me a little bit of glass. And I think, in the middle here, I ended up doing a single one of these. I've literally just got to go around and copy this out. But I just wanted to show you the building that I've done. The farm plots are taking forever to make. Unfortunately, I need spoiled food to make them, to make the nutrient solution. And this is taking forever. Has any... No, none has been done at the moment. Whenever any food perishes... Now, has any of this actually gone down? Perish time 18. I was kind of expecting like this one to go. Maybe the food processor has a built-in fridge inside it. That would be quite inconvenient, actually. Literally always running out of these window blocks. And you can see when I go to make it, it needs to make a steel plate and then 10 of those glass plates, 10 of these ones to make one. It takes a while. It does take... Oh, I made a whole load of small ones. Let's stop these. There we go, much better, the big ones. In fact, let's see what these small ones have to offer. Do they have... They have the same sort of shapes to them. I can't get in there. This is the space that I need to fill up here. So let's do the two by ones, and then we can kind of go across the side here. Aha! So I was wondering why I was having so much trouble placing these small blocks. If you actually have a look here... Well, I'm going to hover over this, but I want you to look at the other side of my screen. Got hit points, mass, and placeable. Small vehicle and hover vehicle. So we're just going to have to store these. My misclick completely did me over there. Oh, look, this... This is the side you're supposed to... Oh! I've put this down the wrong way round. But like, I thought the tool bit would go at the back. That kind of made sense to me. But here's the access panel. Okay, we'll have to do something about that at some point to turn that around. Has this made window blocks L? What are we missing here? Glass plate, which means we are missing silicon, which means I need to go off on a mission. So I did a few simple things while I've been waiting for the food to grow. One of the first things I've done is I've come in here, pressed P. I've changed my faction to the Landlord's faction. That's the faction that Landstryder runs. I've also changed the name of this place to Lakeview. I think it's kind of fitting if a little unoriginal. I've put in some cargo boxes as well. Here's a whole load of building materials. These two are just waiting for things. I've also waited for things to go in them. I've also put in this little doorway and a nice little walkway coming down here with some glass railings to look over the lake. And then back here, we can see here some of my crops have grown. So we're going to harvest these. And as you can see, we have already finished the quest. That's the thing. Now it wants me to place a starter block next. Now I'm not sure exactly which block, which starter block it thinks I need. No, I'm not too old. So let's go to the F1 PDF. Build a vessel. Place a starter block. I should imagine is any starter block we choose. So let's go and have a look at what it takes to make one. But I also have something else I want to do while I'm here. Did I bring the glass with me? I didn't. You see these sloped trusses here? I really want them to be glass. I think they deserve to be glass. We'll have this one being truss. We'll have this one with that line all the way across being truss. And stuff like that. Ooh, yeah. But anyway, these ones here I really want to. So let's see what happens if we just... I'm really like super sketch about it. Okay, no, that's good. It's good. It held up. So let's come over here. Eventually, there's going to be a wall there. I want to put a glass window, maybe a wraparound glass window across these two. I've put a little slope in. Should have shown you this. Just a little slope. I was kind of aiming for something a little less steep than that, but this is what we ended up with anyway. So I'm probably going to break that and put it back. Now somewhere here, I didn't want to go in there, I want to go in here. We should have large window blocks. I've only got the one, so I'm going to queue up a few more here. Pa-pow. And then we can go put this one back together, and then I'll do that off camera. So in here, I want the slope, don't press escape, that is not a useful key in this game. Go around like that. Now does this look fitting? Kind of. It could definitely do with a skin on it. You can see how this door is on this wall here. I think I need to put a skin all the way across. Maybe glass around the door. Yeah, I'm not sure about that. But anyway, we want to make a hover vehicle because we keep going for materials. And like, that's good. That's what a major part of this game is all about. But we're going at it with the drill. And the drill is underutilized. It's underpowered, really. What am I missing here? Metal components and cables. Does that mean I'm missing something specific? Cables and copper. You see, so I'm going to now have to go and mine out some copper over there. But this drill only has a return of something like 70% of what you mine. So each node that you mine, you've got a 70% chance of getting the material. I do believe there are better ones on vehicles to be used, so we're going to explore that. But right now, I need to go and get some more material. So according to our tutorial missions, the next thing we need to do is start working on a vessel. Now, I'm going to start working on a hover vessel, because the thing I have to keep on doing is going out and mining for material. So I think that is going to be the end point of what we want of our vehicle. Now, how do we start vehicles? We come in here, we have a look in the very top of the screen, and up here somewhere, we should be able to find, yes, there we go. Base starter, hover vessel starter, small and capital. So we want the hover vessel starter. Let's get this underway. All the stuff that needs to get made with it. That's fine. That's totally fine. We are just going to sit here and watch it happen, though. Alright, and that's our starter vessel. To give some sort of idea of how long that took, you see the time underneath my map up there. If you just kind of times that by 4, that's the time that passed. Or at least the time that started, minus the time when I finished, and that's the time that's passed. So we've put a new hover vessel block down. It immediately fell to the floor. I have no idea if that's a thing we're supposed to be worried about or not. But we need to add some essential vessel blocks. We need a cockpit, a reaction control system, a generator, and a fuel tank. Now, hopefully, all of this nice and easy to find in here. I think the first thing we're going to have a little trouble with, though, unless I'm massively mistaken, is the cockpit. Now, this has got to be in here, hasn't it? It's got to be a tech tree. In fact, look at all of these things. We need the cockpit, the two... which fuel tank should we take? Well, unlock that cockpit. We'll take... Oh, that's an O2 tank, not a fuel tank. So we'll take the fuel tank as well. What was the other things they say we definitely needed? It was the RCS. I've got a feeling the hover's going to be a thing, but let's have a look. Cockpit, RCS, generator, and fuel tank. So the generator is the thing we're missing. I'm like, oh no, we've got it there, but it's not. It's on here. Generator, fuel tank, RCS, and cockpit. Right, that should be everything. Let's see what this is going to take to queue up. RCS. I wish there was an easier... Oh, there is an easier way. Look, hover vehicles up there. Okay, RCS, cockpit, fuel tank, and is that the generator? That is the generator. Now, whether all of these are going to get made or not is beyond me. Look at this. We're running out of silicon, cobalt. We're generally just a little bit short of everything. So we're going to have to try and do something about that at some point. Things have stopped. Why have things stopped? Are we out of power? I hope we're not out of power. Let's go and have a look over here. We're out of power. That's okay. We can do this again. Yeah, totally out of power. What a thing, hey? What a thing. We're going to have to go looking for some Promethium. I've got a few there. I think the next thing we need to do, whilst this is all building up here, is possibly... Oh, wait. I am filtered. Let's get rid of that. Make another 100 of those. That sounds right. Yeah, let's do that. Okay, now obviously I am doing all of this manually, but there is no reason for me to do so. If I press, not F3, press the wrong button there, I think it's F2, you can see I've got a whole load of blueprints here, and I've even gone and downloaded a few blueprints to make some mining vessels here. The problem with that is I don't think that'll finish my tutorial missions, and that's kind of the thing I really want to do, is finish my tutorial missions. So we're going to do it this way instead. I'm going to pop that there. This might stop me being able to get to the underside, but I literally have no idea how you would raise that sort of stuff up. The fuel tank is a lot smaller than I was expecting. Let's have a look at these other bits. Generator there, and what's this, RCS? Okay, that's a thing we can work on. So let's think about how this is going to work. Can we put like the fuel tank on one side, the generator on the other, and then the RCS in the middle? I think I might actually start by putting the RCS here. That is, first, let's double check that that is what it is. Yes, the RCS. I've got a feeling that probably needs to be on the outside. But who knows? And then we're going to put a fuel tank on this side. And then the generator. I wonder if we can... Well, of course we can. This game is all about customization. Swap it around like that. That's a nice little block of stuff in there. Now we need to add some thrusters. Oh, man, this is the worst-looking vehicle I think I've ever built in my entire life. But we're just trying to get the idea down of how to make a vehicle. And no doubt... Oh, wait. I'm going to look for thrusters in there. But you just know thrusters are not going to be in here so far. No, I mean, I'm not even sure where I would look. Oh, look, you could put a radar dish on one of them as decoration. That's nice. But let's go and try and have a look for thrusters inside our tech tree. It's got to be the hover vessel, of course, as we do keep saying, and somewhere in here, oh look, there's lots of other passenger seats and an open cockpit and stuff like that. That's nice. So here's the hover engine. You would imagine that would be the one we're looking for, so I'm going to buy that just in case. We've got some boosters and some cargo boxes and stuff like that. These are all good, but not quite what I'm after. None of them just say thruster though, so I'm going to assume that the hover engine is the one we're after. I'm having a look through, see if there's anything else I need. What's this mobile constructor? That sounds like something. Device used for crafting. Limited number of templates available. Slow crafting speed. Okay, that's nice. That's very, very good. So we've got Gatling gun, minigun turret, rocket turret. I'm really looking for some way of it mining. Where are the mining drills? So the mining drills all the way over here on level 10. That's fairly cool. I'm going to go ahead and open up the cargo box, the harvester module. What does this do? Input items. It doesn't actually say. I'm going to reckon it's for cutting down plant material rather than for going at the side of stuff, for drilling holes in terrain, if you see what I'm saying. Okay, so now that we've got all those unlocked, that was possibly a bit too much stuff unlocked there, but who cares? Really? So we're currently filtered to hover vessels, I think. Is that small vessels? That's wrong. We want hover vessels. There we go. And we can see here we've got the harvester module and the drill module. Excuse me. Doesn't really say here what the harvester module is for. You can see it says there that we're drilling. The drill is for drilling. So yeah, I'm not sure exactly. Looking for the thrusters. Hover engine, 1B1. I reckon we're going to need, I don't know, a few of these. Can we make 10? Is that something we can do? We're going to have to wait for these Promethean pellets to go through, which is kind of a good thing because I want to make sure we've got all the fuel. In fact, let's stop that there. 90 seems like a good number. Let's clear all this out. Lots of clicks. And go. In the time we've been talking, we've already used 2 bits of fuel, so that's something to bear in mind. Also, the greenhouse is coming along quite well. I've just noticed that I'm starting to get a few frame issues. I wonder what that's about. Shouldn't be a problem. Shouldn't be a problem at all. Must be something just messing up on my PC today. I know, guys, it must be frustrating. I watched that little bit of footage back there and the thrusters were there, right at the top of my vision the whole time. You guys must have been ripping off things that were more important to you than your hair during that entire thing. So sorry about that. So we need to try and figure out how to orientate this so it faces the way we would like it to. Now, to me, we need one out the back. And I know we definitely need one out the front because we want to be able to stop as well. And I hear left and right are the other places to put them, which kind of makes sense. One in every direction. Oh, there is one that I've missed. Of course there is. I kind of wanted to get on with the building and this last one was just being made. So let's spin this round and see what we got. Okay, looking good. It wants me to add an O2 supply now. I'm not too sure about how much I want that to happen, but let's do it anyway. Of course, I've not put this on here. Now I face the question of whether I can cover up my RCS. I'm going to go yes, I probably can. Now we need to add a weapon and an ammo box. I'm not sure about that, whether I want to add the weapon or the drill. I'm not sure if the drill will count, but let's put something up on top. We haven't got anything open yet, so let's have a look in here. Hover vessel, weapons. What weapons we got? A Gatling turret. That sounds like a great idea. Well, it's not a Gatling turret. It's just a forward-facing Gatling gun. Of course, the question we've got to ask is, where would a Gatling gun go best on this ship? And I'm kind of feeling at the top here. Now, that might look a little bit derpy. I mean, we need to do a little bit more mining out before we can get into tunnels. But that's kind of what's going to have to happen. And there is an ammo box. Now, I'm not sure what size ammo the Gatling gun takes. But now they want me to add a docking pad or landing gear. These are things I've never heard of before. Hoffer vehicle, docking pad or landing gear. Ah, it's nighttime now, but as you can see, there is 10 minutes on the sunrise counter. That means there's probably about 40 minutes of nighttime. So I've got the docking clamp in my hand here, and I want to kind of do something a little bit weird. I want to put it on the side of my ship. Oh, it doesn't... Oh, you would have thought it would have liked that, but a thing I've learned is this little hex pattern on the outside, that goes towards your ship. So I'm going to put that there and see what happens. You successfully completed that. It really doesn't look right, though. And now it's like place additional blocks. Now, thankfully, I should have made... Let's just do this... I'm going to make three trusses. 1, 2, 3. That should be nice and simple. And I think I would also like a small cargo box on the back, just in case, you know? Okay, I'm going to start by putting down the cargo container and see if that is the thing it wanted. Like that? No. So I'm going to put a little bit of trussing down. I think I'm actually going to put it on this back here. Just like that. No, it doesn't like additional blocks. Okay, we're going to have to check the PDF and see what it says. Check additional blocks. A cargo box. Yeah, I did that. What? Why is it not saying that that is it? Ah, so it turns out putting the mobile constructor down was the thing that had to happen. I wonder if when I pop these with this, do I get it back? I've got a cargo box back. Okay, I'm going to see if I can get this back as well. Because they look like they really wanted to be the other way around. It looked quite dangerous there breaking those bits, but it worked out all right in the end. So we're going to put that there, and I'm going to put the cargo box here. Maybe we want to just have a standard box there, but I think we're going to get in here, press Y. Oh yeah, let's have a look out here. Press Alt. Ah, so it is a terribly inefficient machine. We can turn around like that. Obviously we need to get out of this alt view. Oh yeah, look at this. This is a machine for cruising around in. The real question is, can we get ourselves up this ramp without destroying the base? I'm not sure. That was the wrong button. Let's try and reset this. We put this back here. Press Alt. Turn it like that and try and just drive in. Is it going to be okay? Yeah, it is. Just about okay. With a little bit of shimmy and shake, everything is all good. And so, with that full day of building, I am going to say thank you very much for joining me for this adventure. I will see you next time when we're going to put this machine to good use. You know we're going to go around and get a whole load of stuff. I also think it's probably time for a facelift. This kind of skin tone was done on a bit of a joke, and now I seem to be a little bit stuck with it. But yeah, I will see you then when we're going to do that. Bye! Oh, that is such a jump. Look at that. Oh, no jump animation at all. Well, anyway, bye!